One central demand of Palestinian protesters this week was annulment of the Paris Protocol. Nassar Ibrahim analyzes how this agreement is part of Israel's ongoing control over the Palestinian people.
In light of the demonstration of the Palestinian people in the Palestinian cities against the raising of the living cost, we heard a lot the term of Paris Economic Protocol. Which means, what's this protocol? What's this? Its importance? What's its role? And how its links with the financial and economic crisis in the Palestinian society, especially in the West Bank in general? We must, in order to understand what is the Paris Protocol, we must return back to 1994. When the PA, the Palestinian Liberation Organization, PLO, signed agreement with Israel, which called in that time until today Oslo Accord. Oslo Accord, it has two sides, the political side, which decide and put in clear the political aspect of the agreement and the relation between the Palestinian side and the Israeli side during the 5 years of the temporary period of Oslo Agreement. And we have also the economic side, which signed on 29th of April 1994. Meanwhile, the political aspect of Oslo Agreement decided the political sealing of the relation between the Palestinian and the Israeli side. The economic side also put in detail the economic relation between the two sides, which cover all the aspects of the economic relation of the Palestinian economy with the Israeli economy. And to understand its danger regards the situation of the Palestinian people, we must remember clearly that Israel, since 1967, the occupation of 1967, they did all their efforts in order to tie the Palestinian economy with the Israeli economy, and they succeed to create a deep dependency, the economic dynamics inside the Palestinian society. And they reform it radically. They controlled the labor force flow from the West Bank and Gaza to Israel. They control all the trade relation of the Palestinian community with the external cycle. Also, they put strong efforts in order to destroy the productive sectors in the Palestinian economy, especially the agriculture, because the agriculture is the main productive sector in the Palestinian society. For that, through the confiscation of land, the expanding of settlements, controlling the water, controlling the borders, they succeed to control this sector and to make it very weak. And they destroyed also the traditional Palestinian crops, such as the orange, the lemon, the olive, the vegetables. And they started to orient the Palestinian agriculture sector to plant the kinds of crops which fit with the Israeli economy, such as the flour, the roses, avocado, strawberry, which will be need water and need to have dynamic and quick procedures in order to meet the needs of the markets. And also, mainly, they control also the labor force, which the main power of the Palestinian labor force worked in Israel. So, regarding Paris Protocol, it's come to not harm this achievement of the Israeli economy and control on the Palestinian society. For that, they put very clear articles which will must be respected from the Palestinian side in order to keep the economic relation to go smoothly between the two sides. And when we are reading the articles of the protocol, we will see it's covered many sectors. First of all, it's put a lot details regards the trade relation of the PA with the external countries. It covered the labor force of the Palestinian, who and how they can flow and to work inside the Israeli economy. It both details regards the export and import from outside, which kinds of goods the Palestinian can import it or export it. And thirdly, the banks and the financial cycles, and also the agriculture and the insurance and the industry, the tourism, all the sectors of the Palestinian economy, it is very clear in the Paris Protocol how they must work in order not to harm in any case the Israeli economy. And when we see what we mean by not harm, when we see, we must see it in this equation. We know that the Palestinian economy is very weak in comparative with the Israeli economy. And we must keep in our mind what I talk about since 1967, the hegemony of the Israeli economy on the Palestinian economy. So the goal of the Paris Economic Protocols is two things. How to keep the privileges of the Israeli economy, which achieved over time, regarding the ties of the Palestinian economy with the Israeli economy, including the market of the Palestinian community. Secondly, to not be developed in order to be in contradiction with the Israeli political goals regards the political process between the Palestinian side and the Israeli side. For that, if we can say that Oslo Agreement in political side, it's the tool of Israel to impose their condition on the Israeli, on the Palestinian leadership, we can see that the Paris Economic Protocol is the economic tool to put more pressure on the Palestinian society and the Palestinian leadership in order not to raise their political demand and to be free from the Israeli control and the Israeli hegemony on their life. What makes it dangerous now, the people, they are saying we can change the Paris Protocol. I think in light the political relation and in light the balances of power and in light the frozen of the peace process, we can't, it's difficult to change radically the Paris Protocol, because to change it radically you must change all the Oslo Agreement process and goals. What the Palestinian can do is to change some details here and there, which will keep the Oslo Protocol as a tool in the hand of the Israeli occupation to continue their policies against the Palestinian people. And I think it is not secret or hidden when we see that the dynamics of control politically and economically through Oslo Agreement or the Paris Protocol, it's the Israeli side they know, and the Western country they know the burden which these tools put on the back, on the heads of the Palestinian people. And they are promoting it, and they didn't do anything since Oslo Agreement until today to help the Palestinian people to be independent economically. They don't want the Palestinian community or the Palestinian people to be independent economically, because that will raise their political goals. For that, we must see and go to read again Oslo Agreement and to see what dangers it has inside it. And finally, to go out from this crisis, what we are seeing today is not a matter of technical issue or to change this price or that. Our economy is dramatically not served the Palestinian people. We are still under occupation, and the Israeli occupation is controlling not only the political and social and the movement of the Palestinians, also they are controlling all our economic life. To go out from the crisis, that means to end the occupation. finally. What we can do now to make it, to give some aspirin or Acamol for the Palestinian to pass this week or the next month, but sooner or later we will be in crisis again.